Howdy, folks. Brother Jim reporting here from End Times Prophecy News. How are you? Well, this is an answer to what Trump actually did. I said I want from the last video I just made. He says, quote, "I am in no hurry. President Trump slams Obama, says he called off yesterday's attack after general told him 150 would die in Iran. President Trump reportedly authorized and then canceled a retaliatory attack on Iran Thursday night for the downing of an unarmed U.S. drone the night before." Trump explained his thinking behind the decision on Friday morning on Twitter. "President Obama made a desperate and terrible deal with Iran," he says, "gave them $150 billion plus $1.8 billion in cash. Iran was in big trouble and he bailed them out, gave them a free path to nuclear weapons and soon. Instead of saying thank you, Iran yelled, 'Death to America!' I terminated deal which was not even ratified by Congress and imposed strong sanctions. They are as much a weakened nation today than at the beginning of my presidency. When they were causing major problems throughout the Middle East. Now they are a bust. On Monday, they shot down an unmanned drone flying in international waters. We were cocked and loaded to retaliate last night on three different sites when I asked, 'How many will die?' 150 people, sir, was the answer from a general. 10 minutes before the strike, I stopped it. Not proportionate to shooting down an unmanned drone. I am in no hurry. Our military is rebuilt, new, and ready to go. By far the best in the world. Sanctions are biting and more added last night. Iran can never have nuclear weapons, not against the USA and not against the world. How does that feel, old bummer?" The truth of it is, Trump loves American people. And you can't put a price on 150 men possibly dying, can you? No. The president started out by slamming Barack Obama and his coddling of the regime in Tehran. So I just wanted to show a couple notes I had on this. Number one, are you praying thy will be done in Father? If you want to do the Lord's will, then isn't praying that his will be done in earth, which is hell, as it is in heaven, doing his will? How are you going to be in the Lord's will if you're praying your selfish prayers of what you want? You can pray whatever you want, but always say, "May your will be done. Lord, if it be your will." Just like Jesus says, "Lord, if it be your will," to the Father, "take this cup from me," which was the cup is to go to the cross. But it wasn't his will, was it? Number two, the fake news once again has couldn't resist to report the news first and wrong. What did they do? They tried to make it look like Trump waffled in his decision and they couldn't understand why, and they didn't name any name administration officials. They just said many administration officials. Why? Well, the same reason why you're probably not going to hear from them what I'm telling you today, that you can't put a price on a man's life, can you? And Trump loves America and especially the military who fights for our freedom. It makes perfect sense. 150 men are more important than $130 million drone being shot down. Is there a price for a man's life? Our president is surely showing he truly loves this country and the people. And another thing I wanted to note to you about the elections. Over 70 to 75% of people listen to alternative news online now. And you know why. But let's put this down to brass tacks. Over 95% of the news on TV and radio is leftist socialist propaganda news. Conclusion: the people have already showed us who they stand for. They are not leftists because 75% of them have had enough. Biden could never win the 2020 election with 7,500 people to a rally versus 150,000 RSVP to Florida's, Orlando, Florida's latest rally for Trump. Are you serious? Are we that dumb? You see, folks, the Dems are losing. The people are not stupid anymore, and all the true news online is being shut up to stop this movement. And all that true news is conservative news sided with most of the Republican Party. The Dems are losing, but it is still the Dems who control the Senate and the House. For their rhinos added to the Dems still dominate the Senate for voting. The devils in hell are madder than ever now because God's servant Trump and the last Trump of God that is working through Trump is in full swing now. This is God's warning to those who have ears. Let him, them who hear what the Spirit is saying unto the churches. As it says, by Jesus Christ, seven times to the seven churches in Revelation chapter 2 and 3. And that's why it's called the time of the heathen. Ezekiel 30 verse 3, for the day is near, even the day of the Lord, which starts right after the rapture. The rapture is what commences the day of the Lord. For the day of the Lord is near, a cloudy day. It shall be the what? Time of the heathen. Even though Hosea wrote this for the children of Israel, it applies to all nations. Hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel, for the Lord hath a controversy with the inhabitants of the land, because there is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land. By swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery, they break out and blood toucheth blood. Therefore shall the land mourn. That's right, the land. And everyone that dwelleth therein shall languish with the beasts of the field and with the fowls of heaven. Yea, the fishes of the sea also shall be taken away. Yet let no man strive nor reprove another, for thy people are as they that strive with the priests. Therefore shalt thou fall in the day, and the prophet also shall fall with thee in the night, and I will destroy thy mother. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God. I will also forget thy children. As they were increased, so they sinned against me. Therefore will I change their glory into shame. And 2 Timothy 3:13, but evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. Thank you. Let me be serious with you. I would rather that you donate to my ministry directly. I cannot survive financially to keep this ministry and new service going without your help. And we all know their plans to shut me down again. But many of you would like to receive a gift or a product as a token of my appreciation. And I don't blame you. Isn't it about time Uncle Sam started paying you instead of you paying him? It is about time. The federal government pays you your rent check. The government rents out thousands of buildings instead of buying them every year. This is all funded by the current $11.1 billion building fund in our budget. Get your free federal rent check today. Sign up with the federal millionaire information here down below. Become a shareholder to receive federal rent checks for life by making a one-time investment as a shareholder. An IRS ruling declares this to be totally legal. This is no joke, no scam, and been for many years. The longer your name is on the distribution list, the larger your federal rent check grows. As inflation rises along with real estate, the government pays you more every year. Starting out as little as $1,800 a month would be your rent check. Wouldn't that be nice to receive every month a rent check like that? The federal government continues to raise your income as inflation rises. This puts an end to retiring with a fixed income that leaves you going broke as you get older. This will put a major dent in those people who hate their home taxes going up every year, wouldn't it? And folks, the price for this valuable information will cost you only $39 a year or $79 for a 2-year membership. Sign up today.